This is Patrick from Guy in the Cube, and today I have an amazingly special guest with me, Mr. Alex Powers. Alex, before we get into any of this, why don't you tell the people who you are and what you do?
Awesome. My name is Alex Powers. I work at Microsoft. I'm part of the Fabric Cat team, and I focus primarily on data integration. I love Power Query. I love Data Factory, Power Query, everything hashtag out there.
You and I talk about Power Query a lot. Is there AI in Power Query right now? There's too much.
No, there's so much.
There's so much. All right. So Alex, I think you're going to show us some of these AI capabilities that's already been in Power Query, I think, for a long time, but we're going to go on a journey. All right. So enough of all this talking. You know how we like to do. Let's do what? Let's head over to Alex's laptop.
Awesome. So here we are within the modern Power Query experience. If you've not seen this before, a lot of the ribbon feels like an M365 product with these updated buttons. I actually want to do this first example, though, which is going to be the add a column just by from an example. So from here, we're going to go to the add column tab, and we're going to choose this column from examples with a little lightning bolt. What we is doing now is saying, hey, just go ahead and type in some sample values. Now I'll try and figure out what you're doing. So here we're going to type in Maria Anders. I'm going to do an open parenthesis, and then she is a sales representative, close parentheses, press enter, and immediately it now shows us all these different lightning bulbs here saying, hey, I think I've figured out your pattern. Up here, we can also confirm with the generated formula that's been written for us. So whether it be like simple examples, whether it be more complex ones, just type it in, and then AI will go ahead and detect it. So this is the sales contact role, press enter, okay. And we've now added that step into our query here.
How long is this little bit of AI been in Power Query?
It's been a while. We should be throwing at birthday parties at this point. That's how old it's
getting.
We should
be throwing at birthday parties. That's number one. So give me another one. There's got to be more. You said there's several AI capabilities.
Awesome. So this one, I'm going to use a simple URL. We're going to go ahead and just grab all the different Power Query connectors that exist. So I'm going to go to the home. I'm going to go to get data. And then just from a web page, I'm going to paste this URL in now. Then when we click next, we'll get the get data preview window, which now displays for us all the different HTML elements here on the left-hand side. But I really want to use this add table using examples because, you know, some of these they preview, but they don't quite have everything that I was looking for. Yeah, that's way too much. So let's do the add table from examples. So the first one I'm going to type in was the Access database by Microsoft. It's looking, it's learning, it's figuring out the pattern here now for us by Actress. Two samples now provided. Awesome. So it's gotten all the A's taken care of here. So that's pretty amazing. But I think there's probably A's, then there's B's, and then there's C's. So let's try this one. So we're going to do the BI connector by guidance. It'll provide it the next group. Awesome. So it's gotten all my B's, it's gotten all my C's, it's gotten all my D's. So instead of having to do this, you know, however many letters are in the alphabet, just go ahead and press OK. It builds that column now here for us, that entire table. And then we'll get this preview, and then we can go ahead and press create. So it did all 26 throughout the alphabet here.
I never thought about, like, I'd start typing and give it one example. And if it didn't work, a lot of time I'd abandon it. I'm like, ah, you know what? I'm more efficient than this AI. So let me go and do this myself. But give it a little more information, right? Teach it a little bit. So you got to train your model, and it'll produce some stuff more efficient for you. All right. That's number two, Alex. Give us another one. I know there's more.
Awesome. This is one of my favorites. I never hear anyone talking about it, though. So I'm going to go ahead and highlight this address. We're going to go to the home, get data, text, or CSV file. We'll go ahead and paste this in now. And then we're going to notice a pretty vertical list of data. Patrick, here, it looks like this is probably from like an old mainframe green screen, crazy outputs that often occur. I do see somewhat of a pattern, though, you know, right? We've got the one Chevy Silverado 2001, two Suzuki. So it does look like there's something here. Yeah. Thinking about it from like a Power Query sense, I'd have to add like an index. I'd have to try and pivot, unpivot, remember which one is the right one. I think we could figure this out though by hand if we really needed to. But why, when we have this amazing button here in the bottom right-hand corner, what does that say, Patrick?
Add table using examples.
All right, providing a little bit of examples again.
Yeah.
So this one, we have our index, we have that ID, we have the make. We have the model, we have the year, it's kind of our columns that we can start thinking about. Provide one example here with the one, let's do the next one with two, let's do the next one with three. It's like, all right, I'm still not able to figure out what you're trying to attempt. So let's do Chevrolet, let's do the Silverado 2500 extended cab, and let's do that 2001.
Wow, it just autofills. It does all the work for me.
Yeah, just a couple patterns and sample values, press create, and then look at this applied step list here on the right-hand side, Patrick.
Wow. Hey, let me take a look at this code, because I may want to write this from scratch instead of letting AI do this for me. Yeah, no, never mind. I changed my mind fast. Okay, go back.
We didn't need a copilot in this example. It was already built in, a button that was right there waiting for us. We just always skip over it every time because we just jump right to the create. But if we slow down a little bit, the AI is likely right there.
All right, what was that, three? I think that's number three. Hit us with another one, Alex.
Data profiling, and I know everyone's going to roast me in the comments, but you know what? It is what it is. I'm not pulling out a calculator. I'm not doing all the math. So I'm going to use some of the profiling and statistics that exist built into the Power Query. So here within the options, there's this enable column profiling, and then we will go and have all these automatically on by default with selecting that. Go ahead and press OK. And now it's just doing a quick review of the first kind of 100 or entire data set. If we were to go down to the bottom here, 1,000 rows or entire data set. So in this example, it's scanning the columns. It's saying there may be a lot of uniques or distincts. In this example, if we were to look at something like the contact title, you can see we've got quite a bit of people here in the sales representative role, marketing role. Of course, if we wanted to, we could group by the text length. The longer the title, the more important you are. So we've got a couple people here with 20 characters in their title. Of course, if we wanted to filter that now, we can do that, just equals or doesn't equal to kind of remove those values. And then this also applies to like numerical columns. So here in this example, supplier ID, if we were to do kind of the same group by, we could look at sign or parity. But again, I talked about like all of this math that's being done as we look at the different columns. So what's the distinct, what's the min, max, average, standard deviation, even count, odd count. There's just so much that's built in here with the column profiling.
Adam and I talk about optimizing your model a lot. And this gives you some insight even before you get that data into your semantic model and go look at the VertiPack analyzer and things like that. You probably can do some cleanup because this is where you should do your cleanup at. A lot of people discount this feature, but it's a very powerful feature. All right, that's number four, Alex. You got one more for us?
Awesome. So when do we get those Microsoft forms in, Patrick, where everyone's submitting their stuff and there's misspellings and we didn't like have any hard-coded values to ensure like the data quality here. So we have Apple, we have APL, you've got pineapple, of course, my favorite, watermelon, just a little bit misspellings. This is what we actually needed though, right? Like we need these consistent values. So what we're going to do is we're actually going to kind of have a little bit of a map in here. There are like some misspellings and we're going to kind of merge these. So in this example, the home, we're going to go to the combine. We'll do merge queries. So for our bottom table here, we're going to use this fruit. Awesome. So the two, been able to match about 2 out of 9 rows, Patrick, not looking pretty good here. Wow. We can do a lot of complex if this, then that statements and add new custom columns, but really I want to use this fuzzy matching. So let's go ahead and turn this on. It's now evaluating. It says I can probably get about 8 of the 9 done here just based on the table now. If I allow some approximate values, similarity threshold, you know, how close can they be in terms of approximation, about 0.8 here, ignoring some casing. But what I want to do is I want to make sure that we have one match for each row. And then I want to use a transformation table here. So that was that mapping table. We're at a from start and then a 2 as the end in terms of our corrections. We're now at 9 of 9. So if we press okay, and then let's go ahead and take a look at this. If we expand this fruit, perfect, fuzzy merging.
And we're all matched up. This is just AI on top of AI on top of AI. So I thought you just had one more, but hey, who am I not to want more AI? Give us another one, Alex.
Awesome. So one of my favorite ones here is going to be merging because we do it all day long, bringing tables together. So we're going to do a merge between our dim product and our dim product subcategory tables. So here in this example, I've got dim product up top, subcategory down below. And then Patrick, did you see what happened?
I need you to slow down and do it one more time because it happened so fast and I can't believe this.
So here in this example, you know, it was very subtle and maybe some people have missed it, but up in the top right hand corner, there's now suggestions that have been identified for us. So as we hover above here now, I see that there's 2 matches. So either subcategory key to subcategory key, that seems like a likely candidate, or the product key to the product category key. So actually this one is probably the one we're looking for, right?
That's a pretty nice feature and capability. So instead of me searching and scrolling and looking for it, I just press that. It identifies what I need. And it even gives me, you know, the recommendations that I can choose the one that works. This is absolutely amazing. So if you don't have Copilot yet, there's lots of AI already built in the product. If you have any questions, comments for Alex or myself about these AI features, you know what to do. Post them in the comments below. If you want to learn more about Fabric, Power BI, all the workloads in Fabric, there's probably a video flying somewhere above my head. And as always, from Alex, Martha, Adam, and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.